Welcome to yet another video about the exceptional TMS WEB Core 2.0 release. In this video, we're going to look at additional APIs that have been added. We're going to focus on two. First, the multi-screen API. Yes, you heard correctly. Usually, a web browser is limited to a single window. Your application runs in that browser window. But with TMS WEB Core, you're able to access multiple displays. But you're not only able to get information about the number of displays, you can get the resolution for each display, for example, and you have full control to open multiple windows on each of your screens. A very detailed example for a weather application is found in the demos folder in the basics directory, and there is the multi-screen demo. And also, if you want to learn all the details about the implementation of the multi-screen API, go to the blog on tmssoftware.com, post number 918. The link is on this slide. The second API that has been added is an amazing feature for speech recognition. Not only can speech be translated in text, meaning strings that you can't process in your application, no, you can even specify language commands with a special syntax that your application reacts with source code to certain speech patterns. And this is what we're going to look at next. This demonstration is also part of TMS WEB Core. Just like the multiple screens, it's impossible to show this with a recorded video because I'm talking through my microphone right now, so the microphone handle is blocked. I can't use the microphone at the same time in this web application. Let me just point out what this application can do. If you speak after unmuting your microphone, you might also have to tell your web browser that your web application is allowed to use the microphone. That is something that is out of the scope of your TMS WEB Core application. That is something you have to authorize either once or each time, depending on how you reply to the dialogue. But still, this application will record all the words, sentences that you say and print them into the memo control on that page. In addition to that, there are certain commands that have been defined, like delete line certain number, delete last line, clear memo. And also, the key thing here is that the line, for example, here has been denoted optional in the delete last. So you can either say delete last or delete last line. Both will have the same effect. An even more complex syntax is possible if you look at the save to as file name, which allows you to have very complex language to accommodate certain tasks. The amazing thing is that this is so easy to use. You drop the TWEB speech recognition control on the form, and first you specify language, either EN UK, EN US. This is a very common language specifier used in Windows. The first one is the primary language, and the second one determines the region that the language is being used. That's why English is separated between the UK and the United States, for example. The same is true for German, German in Germany, DEDE, and German in Austria, for example. The next thing to notice is the commands property. And that is where you can specify language commands that your control is supposed to react to. And each command, let me expand it right here, has certain properties. The value in this case specifies the language that is supposed to be recognized. So in this case, clear memo, no further syntax. The next one is a little bit more interesting. This is save to as file. Those three are optional. And the last one, file, can be more than one word. The simple one that I'll look at in detail is delete line number. So you can either say delete, or you can say delete line 27. The number, just like in database SQL statements, the colon indicates it's a parameter right here. And how can you specify the source code that is triggered? Of course, in an event using on command in this case. The parameters are passed as a tstring object instance, so you can simply iterate them using for s in parameters. And then after parsing the result, you can delete the line from the memo control that is specified as a parameter. The same is true for the other commands. For example, saving to a file, you pick the first parameter that is, or the simplest case, if it is the clear memo command, it's simply webmemo1.clear. No further implementation is needed to implement this amazing functionality. Finally, to activate speech recognition, meaning what happens if you click on the microphone to enable speech recognition, you call the method start. And then you have two more, resume and abort. These are the three states that you need in order to enable, disable, or continue speech recognition. The only thing that is a little bit cumbersome, but it's caused by the underlying API, the first time you call start, and each second time you don't call start, you call resume. On the other side, in order to stop speech recognition, it's always the method called abort. And that's all there is to know about speech recognition with TMS Web Core and the multi-screen API. But wait, there is more. Unlike Disney, in its latest animated feature, we always talk about Bruno and with Bruno. And Bruno enjoys talking to you in his webinars, presenting new features of TMS Web Core. This webinar is no different. If you go to the link on this slide, you get a full webinar for free where Bruno Ferenc presents all the features of TMS Web Core 2.0 in detail. And if you haven't downloaded TMS Web Core yet, go to web.tmssoftware.com to find more information, download links for your version of Delphi.